Have you made it out of Fafnir's storeroom yet?
Where do we go from here? It's another Valkyrie. Can we try to free her?
We can't just leave her like this, brother.
Do not rush me, Ed. When we are prepared, I will attack. Freedom.
Where is your queen?
My queen?
She did this to you. She's letting the dead take over Midgard.
This cannot be.
I didn't want to believe it either, m'lady. But we have to find her.
Where is she?
I can't say for sure, but... the Rockstall of Valkyrs. If the Council of Eight are reunited, perhaps she will answer our call.
Looks like this was our last one.
Aye, lad. Onto the rope stole our Valkyrs then. If you remember, it's next to the two oarsmen statues on the path we took to Thamur's chisel.
This queen of yours, she is strong, yes? Stronger than these other Valkyries we have faced.
That's putting it mildly, brother.
Then we must prepare ourselves.
I wonder what became of him.
Wait, Fafnir? Like, Fafnir's storeroom, Fafnir?
The very one.
But Sindri said he was a dwarf.
He was. And now he's a dragon. Funny how life works, isn't it?
He's chained up.
Perhaps we should keep an eye out for binding shrines and free the poor bastard. Aye, lads? Source of annoyance amongst Aesir and Vanir alike.
Then why free him?
Trust the recently liberated brother. No one deserves to be held captive like this. Even a greedy little dwarf come dragon. I don't know for certain, though I'd wager his penchant for stealing magical artifacts had something to do with it. He's stolen a trinket from the wrong Vanir goddess.
Remember you?
I don't know, lad. A lot's changed since we last crossed paths. I had legs.
Boy.
Hold on. Let me read this.
Go, you wee little bugger. Well, the dragon hasn't done much for his personality.
Poor Fafnir. There's a fine line between ambition and greed, you know.
This is it, right? The Rockstall?
Aye, lad. The Council of Valkyries.
The Valkyries are of Valhalla, are they not?
Glad to see you're paying attention, brother. You are correct. Valhalla, the Great Hall of the Einherjar, is their home within Asgard. But while there, they are subject to the scrutiny of the Allfather himself. And relations between the Valkyries and Odin were tense during my tenure as his advisor.
Why?
Well, that's an even longer story, lad. For now, why don't we look around for some clues?
Whoa, you're back! Hello?
I don't think she can hear you, lad. The helms must only retain but a small portion of their owner. I'd wager the rest is in transit to Valhalla to try and fix the mess left by their absence.
Oh! Yeah!
You have saved the Valkyries.
Sigrun, how did this happen?
Mimir, is that you? You have been freed, but...
Freedom comes at a price, milady.
You speak truly. Countless winters we serve the Allfather. But only through his union to the Queen did we ever taste some measure of freedom.
But aren't you the Queen?
There has only been one Queen of the Valkyries, the Goddess Freya. When Odin severed her wings, I served in her absence, but it wasn't enough for the Allfather. He used an archaic piece of magic, corrupting my sisters. I tried to contain the damage by imprisoning them in places where they could cause no harm, but soon I lost myself as well.
Sigrun, I'm sorry for being so worthless. I could have done something, or tried at the very least. What will you do now?
I must reunite with my sisters. Together we can restore balance to the realms. You have the eternal blessings of the Valkyries.
Did it, I suppose.
You don't sound very happy about it.
It's difficult to be happy about anything when you're a reanimated head. I'm grateful we were able to set the Valkyries free. But so much of this could have been avoided, if only...
You said it yourself, Head. It does not matter anymore. The past is the past.
Well, that's awfully cheerful coming from you.
I am in a good mood. The dwarves will make use of this helm.
Your dad's a wee bit single-minded, isn't he, lad?
Definitely.